students, have you ever given a thought that why mostly atoms are incapable of independent existence? Why do they combine? Why two atoms of hydrogen combine to form a hydrogen molecule? Or why two atoms of oxygen combine to form an oxygen molecule? Similarly, the four atoms of phosphorus combine to form a phosphorus molecule. These atoms not only combine with the atoms of the similar element, but the atoms of the different elements also combine. For example, atom of hydrogen and oxygen combine to form a water molecule. An atom of carbon combines with the atom of oxygen to form a carbon dioxide. Why do atoms combine? And how do these atoms combine? We will study it today. Today's topic is chemical bonding. But let's first of all know what is a molecule. Molecule, a group of atoms existing as one species and having characteristic properties is called a molecule. A molecule is made up of two or more atoms. There must be some force which is holding these two atoms. What is that force? That force is a chemical bond. The force which holds the atoms together within a molecule is called a chemical bond. Now again, there are so many questions which arises out of this. Why do atoms combine? Why are only certain combinations possible? For example, why only two hydrogen atoms combine to form hydrogen molecule? Why H2 only? Why not H3? Similarly, another question, why do some atoms combine while certain others do not? For example, hydrogen combine to form a hydrogen molecule, but helium atoms do not combine to form a helium molecule. There is no molecule like He2. Why is it so? We will study today why such combinations are taking place. Why do atoms combine? The Cosson-Lewis approach to chemical bonding. Electronic theory of valency. Noble gases were studied and it was found that these gases are chemically inert, they do not show any reactivity and they are highly stable. Their electronic configuration suggested that they have 8 electrons in their outermost shell. The exception is helium, which has only 2 electrons in its outermost shell. The outermost shell is also known as the valence shell. The presence of the 8 electrons in the outermost shell make noble gases highly stable and chemically inert. Now, the presence of the 8 electrons in outermost shell is called octet, or 2 electrons in the case of helium is called duplet. Duplet is completed by 3 elements, hydrogen, lithium and beryllium. The octet rule. The atoms of the different elements combine with each other in order to complete their respective octet, that is 8 electrons in their outermost shell, or duplet, that is having 2 electrons in the outermost shell to attain stable nearest noble gas configuration. How do atoms combine? That is the mode of the chemical combination. There are 2 modes of chemical combination. One is by complete transfer of the electron from one atom to the other atom. That type of bond is known as electrovalent or ionic bond. The second way is by sharing of electrons. The 2 atoms, they contribute the electrons. The electrons are shared and a bond is formed. This type of bond is known as a covalent bond. But there is another type of sharing that is known as a coordinate bond. In a coordinate bond, both the electrons, they are contributed by only one of the atom but shared by both the atoms. Now I'll take the bonds one by one. But before taking it again, I'll tell you the valence electrons. The valence electrons are the electrons which are in the outermost or the valence shell. And these are the electrons which play the major role in the formation of a chemical bond. Now on the slide you can see that there are the symbols of the elements and there are the dots around them. These dots are the valence electron. For example, in the case of hydrogen, its atomic number is 1, it has only 1 electron, so it is shown by only 1 dot. In the case of carbon, its atomic number is 6, the inner shell has 2 electron and the outer shell has 4 electron. These 4 electrons are shown by 4 dots. Similarly, nitrogen, oxygen, chlorine and other elements are shown. This method of representing the valence electrons was suggested by G. N. Lewis. He said that I am bored of the inner electrons because the major part and the main role is played by the valence electrons. So let's show only the valence electrons, and these structures are known as electron dot structures. Ionic bond. When the electronegativities of the two atoms are quite different from each other, then one atom loses an electron or electrons and the other atom gains an electron or electrons, and this results in the formation of an ionic bond. So we see that there should be an electronegativity difference between the two atoms, and it mainly happens when one of the atom is a metal and the other element is a non-metal. Metals, they have the tendency to lose the electrons, they are electropositive, and the non-metals, they have the tendency to gain the electrons, they are electronegative. And by this transfer of the electrons, the cation and the anion is formed, and there is an electrostatic force of attraction between the oppositely charged ions. Now I'll explain it with the help of an example. Now you can see that ionic bond is formed between sodium and chlorine. The electron which is shown by the yellow dot is of sodium, which is transferred to the chlorine. And sodium acquires the positive charge and chlorine acquires the negative charge, and then there is an electrostatic attraction between the positive and the negative ion. Now I will show you the formation of ionic bond in case of sodium chloride. Sodium, the symbol is Na, its atomic number is 11. It has 11 electrons and the electronic distribution is 2, 8, 1. It has 1 electron in its valence shell. Chlorine, atomic number is 17. The electronic distribution or the electronic configuration is 2, 8, 7. Now we can see that sodium has 1 valence electron and the chlorine has 7 valence electrons. Both these elements tend to have the octet. Octet means 8 electrons in the valence shell. Now, sodium will easily lose this 1 electron and transfer this electron to chlorine. This way, sodium acquire positive charge and will have 8 electron in its outermost shell. And the chlorine will acquire a negative charge and it will also have 8 electrons in its valence shell. Both their octets are complete. And because they are positively and negatively charged, so there will be an electrostatic attraction. They will attract each other and a bond is formed. The bond so formed is known as ionic bond. Let us see some more examples. This is the crystal of NaCl. Lithium, electronic distribution you can see. This is fluorine. Again, you can see the electrons in the different shells. Now, the electron from the lithium transferred to fluorine. Lithium acquires the positive charge and the fluorine acquires a negative charge, and the molecule of lithium fluoride is formed. Another example, beryllium. Atomic number of beryllium is 4. It has 4 electrons, two in the inner shell and two in the outer shell. Again, fluorine atoms, atomic number 9, 2 in the inner shells and 7 in the outermost shell. Now, again there will be transfer of electron from beryllium to fluorine. Beryllium acquires now 2 positive charge and the fluorine acquires negative charge. And this way, there will be an attraction between the positively charged ion and the negatively charged ion, and ionic bond will be developed. The next type of the bond is covalent bond. Covalent bond is formed when electronegativities of the bonding atoms are the same, as they are in the diatomic molecules or close to the same, they share electrons. Bond form when atoms share electrons are called covalent bonds. Electron dot formulas, that is Lewis structures for covalent compounds. When atoms form covalent bonds, they are trying to achieve stable noble gas electronic arrangements. Hydrogen will share electron until it feels 2 electrons like helium. Other elements share electrons to achieve what is called a stable octet, that is 8 electron in the valence shell. In the covalent bond, the sharing will take place. The covalent bonds are different types. There is a single covalent bond. When only one electron pair is shared between the two atoms, the single covalent bond is formed. For example, hydrogen. Each hydrogen contributes one electron and a single covalent bond is formed between the two hydrogen atoms. Double covalent bond. When two pair of electrons are shared between two atoms, the double covalent bond is formed. For example, oxygen. Two oxygen atoms share two electron pairs and a double bond is formed. Triple covalent bond. When three pair of electrons are shared between two atoms, then a triple covalent bond is formed. Example, nitrogen. Between two atoms of nitrogen, the three electron pairs are shared. Now you can see from this figure how two oxygen atoms are combined and the electrons are shared. This is the electron dot formula for methane. Each hydrogen atom shown by the red color and with the red electron, and the carbon surrounded by 4 valence electron. Now carbon will complete its octet and hydrogen will complete its duplet. Now both are in the stable state and the methane, that is CH4, is formed. This is electron dot formula for ammonia, NH3. Nitrogen has 5 valence electrons and hydrogen has 1 electron each. Again, hydrogen will complete its duplet and nitrogen will complete its octet. See, the nitrogen has completed its octet and hydrogen has completed its duplet and both are in the stable state. When electrons are shared unequally between the two atoms, the bond is called a polar covalent bond. When a bond is formed between the two elements and the electrons are shared, but one of the atom is more electronegative, then the shared pair of electron shifts towards the more electronegative element, as in the case of water. In water, oxygen is more electronegative than hydrogen. So, the shared pair of electron is shifted towards oxygen and oxygen acquires partial negative charge and hydrogen acquires partial positive charge. You can very well see from the figure that the two dots that are electrons are shifted towards oxygen but shared by both of them. And due to this shifting of the electrons, the bonds are polar. So, such type of bonds are called polar covalent bond. This is again one example of CF4, where carbon has completed its octet and fluorine has also completed its octet by sharing of electrons. This is hydrogen sulfide molecule. again the completion of the octet by sulfur and completion of the duplet by hydrogen. Now you have seen the two types of the bonds, the ionic bond and the covalent bond. Both are very important, but their basis is the difference in the electronegativity. When there is the difference in the electronegativity, the bond formed is ionic bond, that is by the transfer of electron, and when the electronegativities are almost same, then the bond form is the covalent bond, that is by the sharing of electrons. But the purpose is same, that is to complete the octet or duplet and to achieve the noble gas configuration, which are very stable and chemically inert. Dear students, you must have understood why these atoms are so friendly, why they are combining with each other, why they are combining with the atoms of the other elements. The motive is only one, to have the most stable electronic configuration, the configuration of the noble gases. You can say just to have 8 electrons in their valence shell. Thank you.